डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई डिस्कस अबाउट लिशेजस फिगर। ओके, सो वी आर एक्चुअली इन अ चैप्टर दैट इज सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन। वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन एंड प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस्ड लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स अबाउट सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन एंड यू नो दैट फॉर एग्जीक्यूटिंग सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन वी नीड अ स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन अ पार्टिकल that is called restoring force. And at first we have discussed about the simple harmonic motion, and the influence of the simple harmonic motion is restoring force, and only one restoring force is involved. First we have discussed about simple harmonic motion where only one force was involved, but then we have discussed simple harmonic motion where two forces are involved. Two restoring forces are involved, but the two forces acting on a particular particle and produce SHM along x direction. As we have seen from this displacement equation, that is x1 is equal to a1 sin omega t and x2 is equal to a2 sin omega t. So two forces acting on a particle and produce SHM along x direction, that is superposition of SHM. We have discussed in the previous class, but the superposition is only along x direction. But now we are going to discuss about two forces acting on a particle. One produce SHM along x direction and other produce SHM along y direction. That is, the two SHM produced by two forces on a particular particle is along two perpendicular direction. So the particle is influenced by two restoring force, and the effect that is produced by two restoring force, one is along x direction and another is along y direction. So there will be a resulting motion, and the resulting motion that we will discuss here that resultant motion, which is according to the two restoring force and are acting perpendicular to each other. So let me take first the first particle, along the first force along would produce SHM on the particle is along x direction and is given by x is equals to a sin omega. And the second restoring force produces simple harmonic motion along y direction, that is, and the equation of motion is, or displacement equation that is produced by the second restoring force is y is equal to b sin omega t plus phi. So these are the two displacement equation perpendicular to each other, and these two displacement equation, one is x is equal to a sin omega t, another is y is equal to b sin omega t. And if you study these two equation, we can see that here the amplitude, that is a and b, are different. Here x is equal to a sin omega t, here y is equal to b sin omega t. So the amplitude are not same, the amplitude are different here. Here a and here is b, and a is not equals to b. And the other thing is the phase difference between these two is phi, because here is omega t and here is omega t plus phi. So the phase difference between these two is phi. But the most important thing is that the frequency are same. Here is also omega t, here is also omega t. So here we will discuss a very simple thing, a simple case when the frequency is same. But if the frequency are different, then the discussion is beyond the scope of our syllabus. We will not discuss over here what will happen if the frequency are also be different. So our goal is very determined, that we are going to discuss about the particle executing SHM, the resulting motion of this particle. We are going to discuss about the resulting motion of the particle, but the forces acting, or the displacement equation, or the effect of the two restoring forces on the particle is along two perpendicular directions. One is along the x direction, another is along the y direction. And the two equation has x equals to a sin omega t, and another one is y equal to b sin omega t plus phi. but the difference is the amplitude of the displacement, the displacement equation, or the amplitude of the effect of the vibration along x and along y direction are different, and there is a particular phase difference, that is phi. Now the resulting motion that will occur due to the two restoring forces, and the resulting motion will depend on this A and B, will depend on this phi. Okay, so there will be various kinds of paths followed by the particle. So the resulting motion of the particle will be different, and the different paths will depend on the amplitude A and B and phi, actually the relation between A and B and phi. Okay, and that paths are collectively called, are as Lissa just figure, all the path, that is path means curves here. Okay, each path, that may be a straight path, there may be a circular path, there may be elliptical path, that means the curves associated with the paths are collectively called Lissajous figure. Okay, so from our discussion we can conclude that the definition of the Lissajous figure is like this: the curve traced by a particle which is subjected to two simple harmonic motion in perpendicular direction is called Lissajous figure. The curve traced by a particle which is subjected to two simple harmonic motion, one is along x direction and another is along y direction, that is the perpendicular direction. Okay, and that figures are collectively called Lissajous figures. And we will discuss all the cases, almost all the cases, you can say, one by one, how the curves are produced, the resulting motion, which curve is produced by the resulting motion, we will discuss one by one. Okay, but we will not discuss all the cases because all the cases are not in our syllabus. This lecture is mainly for the J main and NEET. So we are not discuss more about this thing. We can't actually discuss more about these things. And here I have discussed by using a very simple method, not the general method. Okay, there is another way of discussing this thing by using the general method also, but we are not interested to discuss that kind of thing. Here we will discuss a very special case by using a very special approach, you can see. Okay, so let me see how we can see that there is various path traced by the particle. Okay, so now case one, I am going to discuss about case one, and in case one phi is equals to zero, we put phi is equals to zero first. So we have two equations, x is equal to a sine omega t and y is equal to b sine omega t plus phi. Now if phi is zero, then y will be simply b sine omega t and x was a sine omega t. So sine omega t is equals to x divided by a, okay, and sine omega t is equal to y divided by b. So from this equation we can write sine omega t as x divided by a, and from this equation we can write sine omega t as y divided by b. So from equation 1 and 2 we can write it very easily that x by a is equal to y by b. So y is equals to b by a into a, and this is nothing but equation of straight line which is passing through the origin, that is y is equal to mx type, where m is the slope of this straight line, which is b over a, that is tan theta is equal to b over a. So this is a equation of straight line. So the particle will move back and forth along the straight line. Okay, when the phi is equals to zero, so the curve you can see from this figure. Okay, so this is the thing, and here we can see that if b is equals to a, if we put that b is equals to a, then that will be a special straight line which is tan theta equals to 1, that is theta equals to 45 degrees. The slope of the straight line will be 45 degrees. Okay, so this is a very special type of motion of this particle. So the resulting motion of the particle here is straight line. So this is a curve traced by the particle, and this curve is straight line. Okay, and so this is one Lissajous figure, you can say. Okay, so now let me take the next page also, the second case in the next page. Now let me discuss case two. Okay, so in case two we have taken phi is equals to what? We have taken phi is equals to pi by 2. Okay, so here we have taken that phi is equals to pi by 2. So now what will be the relation? Here x will be a sin omega t as before. So sin omega t will be x divided by a, and y is equals to b sin omega t plus pi by 2. And this sin omega t plus pi by 2 means cos omega t. So cos omega t is nothing but y divided by b. Now from this equation 1 and 2, if we square this equation 1 and 2 and add, then it will be x square divided by square plus y square divided by b square. Okay. So x square divided by square plus y square divided by b square is sin square omega t plus cos square omega t, that is equals to 1. So the equation will be x square divided by square plus y square divided by b square is equal to 1, and that is the equation of ellipse. So here the path traced by the particle, the curve traced by the particle is ellipse. So the resulting motion is the elliptical motion. Okay. So this is one of the largest figure. This is okay. And here the motion of the particle is along this ellipse in anti-clockwise direction, and we can see it by using the equation that we have x is equals to a sin omega t. Here x is equals to a sin omega t. We have x is equals to a sin omega t. Okay. So if at t equals to 0, x equals to 0. So the particle will be at t equals to 0, x equals to 0. So the particle will be at this point. Okay. And at t equals to 0, y equals to b. So the at t equals to 0, y equals to b and x equals to 0. So the particle is at this position initially. At t equals to 0, the particle is at this position. Okay. That at t equals to 0, x equals to 0, y equals to b. So the particle, this is the point, because this is a. Okay. This distance is a, because that the total distance is 2a. So this is the same major axis. So this will be a, and this is the same minor axis. So this will be b. Okay. This will be b. So the this point is actually 0 comma b. So the particle at t equals to 0, the particle is at this point. Now if t increases, okay, if t increases, then y decreases from this equation. As t increases, that is omega t increases, so cos omega t decreases. As y equals to b cos omega t, so if t increases, then omega t increases, and when omega t increases, then cos omega t decreases. So the after a certain time, the particle will be located at this position. So you can tell that this particle will move along this anticlockwise direction. Okay, so along this anticlockwise direction. So you can see this is one of the largest figure, that is the ellipse. Okay, and if we put this a is equal to b, then there will be special case of the ellipse, that will be circle. Okay, so if a equals to b, then the curve will be x square plus y square is equal to a square. This will be the equation, and this is the equation of circle. So instead of ellipse, the particle will move along circle now. So we can see this, depending upon this, the relation between a b and the depending upon phi, there are various cases, there is various path traced by the particle. The resulting motion of the particle will be different, and all the different paths collectively called Lissajous figure. Okay, and we have left one thing also. If phi equals to pi by 4, we are not discussing about this complicated case, but if as a note we can write over here that if phi is equal to pi by 4, then it will be oblique ellipse, and if phi equals to pi, then it will be again a straight line, but now the direction of the straight line will be different. I can tell you the thing, okay, like this. Previously when phi is equal to 0, our straight line was in this direction. This is the straight line, that was y equals to mx, that is y equals to b by a into a. But here, for this case, for phi is equal to pi, it will be in this direction. Okay, it will be in this direction. This will be the straight line. This will be the resulting motion. Similarly, if phi is equal to pi by 4, then the ellipse will be oblique ellipse. And oblique ellipse means, if the ellipse is oblique, then it will be like, you can say, the ellipse is, let me do another thing, okay. If this is a square, okay, this is our 2a and 2b, then what will be the ellipse? The direction of the ellipse will be oblique ellipse means the ellipse, the same major axis and the same minor axis are in this direction. Okay, so the ellipse will be like this. Ellipse will be like this, in this direction. Okay, in this direction, the ellipse will be in this direction. Okay, so the direction of the actually the same major axis and the same minor axis, these axes are inclined to each other. Okay, like this. But here these are perpendicular to each other. Here these are perpendicular to each other. But in case of oblique ellipse, it may or may not be happen. Okay, so these are the different cases you can study in your higher classes. I will not discussing over here. Actually, this is the beyond of the scope. Okay, so thank you.